Today, 9th of February, we are here. We start our compiler class. We are basically cross the midstream. This is the toughest portion, but don't worry. This is the parsing. You know, this is the parsing. It is a after lexical analysis. Then we have a only the tokens are there, and we now after lexical analysis we got a string of tokens. I guaranteed there is all the white spaces are taken out and all these things, and very initial errors are not there. So now come to the parsing. The objective of the parsing is to getting from the terminals. We have to build the parsing tree, or you can say another tree is called abstract syntax tree, which is nothing but a parsing tree which takes up little space. So if it is either we have to get a abstract syntax tree or not, there may be some errors. How to handle those errors from panic error and all. So first thing, though, I always suggest these are evolutionary. All these things, the best parsing techniques is LR1, because LR1 we found it in LR1, and little approximation to LR1 is LALR1. That is the best parsing techniques for all computer languages. Most of our computer languages are LR1. Then you might argue why do you start for LR1 understanding? But it is difficult. We have to learn all these things. Then you can get understand what is LR1 parsing. These are for most of the cases historical reasons. Yeah, this is backtracking. You know, that is very easy. That is, you start from, it's a top down parsing. You start from S, you try every production at order, and whether you are reaching the terminals. If you try all the productions, you are not getting that's all. But because it will work 100% of the time. But why you are not using it? Because it is back and forth. That is the thing. Whenever you see other than, if you are say, think of your automata class, the back and forth until and only Turing machine. The Turing machine can go left and right and all this, and that is the reason Turing machine generally doesn't give. Whenever back and forth, you do not get O(n). But our parsing, our whole goal is we should parse it in O(n). So best machine will be the finite state machine and the push down automata, because push down automata, it can go push pop, and all the input reader, it goes only that direction, only left to right. If you have input buffer where you're all after lexical analysis, all the terminals goes into input buffer, and from input buffer then you have to all go slightly at the end of the dollar is the end of the marker, then we say the parsing is done. So that is no back and forth there. But in backtracking, you try one rule and then you thrown that rule, it is not matching, then that's all the backtracking. So it is never give O(n) performance. So what can be done? Then will come predictive parsing. Predictive parsing is very simple. We take out here predictive parsing. Best predictive parsing is LR1. We take a stack. Everywhere you see in computer science, stack comes to rescue with many points. The stack, in the stack, we put first the whole input string comes here, end is a dollar, and stack initially in LL1 parsing, or we put S here. S is the starting symbol, and that will be completely reversed if we go for bottom up parsing. There S will be the last point. That is logical. It is bottom up, it is a top down. So top down S should be here, and here input string should be here, and then we match it from this S to here terminal by parsing table. We make a parsing table where all the variables there, and what are the columns will be all the terminals, and here left hand side all the variables, and for each variable with each terminal, if we get one and only rule in that parsing table, then we fire this rule, and ultimately this S, it will be finish up, and here it will be finish up, and then you say parsing is succeed. It will go at the end, and the first initial is S should be here, but it is totally reverse in bottom up parsing. Okay, so what is the disadvantage of top down parsing here? Say if S is here start, and if you have a say terminal A, and you can only have beginning starting with S, beginning with A, only one and only rule. that is a bit negative about LLL parsing. So if you have more than rules, then it will be in confusion, the which rule to fire. And you know the hit and trial is not a good, because hit and trial means it is again a backtracking. So backtracking is absolutely no-no. Everywhere backtracking should be avoided. The backtracking can be avoided if we take care of all the rules to be modified so that no rules start with the same terminal. That is a very restriction. And another very restriction is there, that no left recursion, that a rule left hand side a variable and right hand side the same variable cannot be there. So that is a left recursion, and then maybe say indirect left recursion. All these things are absolutely no-no, but left recursion, indirect left recursion can be handled by modifying this your grammar rules. But the thing is that then the grammar is really odd, because grammar is means whether programmers would write programming language within that grammar. When there's, if grammar is so much so much modified for felicitating LL1 parsing, that is no left recursion and all these things, and variables should not start with same terminal, more than one rule is not there. So grammar is looked like more foreign. So that is a negative. Otherwise, LL1 is pretty good. If it is a, if your parsing table is one and only unique entry and you know what are the restrictions are there, that we have covered in our last classes, that is it. But next is, there I have omitted from LL1 parsing, there is another parsing, it's called shift reduce parsing. After shift reduce parsing, it is called LR parsing. So we have to understand backtracking that we have already done, good it. Then predictive parsing is LL1 parsing. LL1 parsing, this is that we have already covered. And this is the shift reduce parsing, the next topic. If you understand the shift reduce parsing, then we'll go LR parsing, LR0 parsing, rather LR0. Then we'll go for LR1 and to simplify LR1 to LLR1. So we have to be very focused that from LL1 parsing, we don't jump to the LR parsing. The middle step is shift reduce. What is shift reduce? I am telling you just from this screen, because that will be better. So in LL1 parsing, or we put S here, start, and the whole architecture of the program same. The program algorithm would be different, table will be different, and the initial status of the stack is different. Initial status of the stack would be nothing in SR parsing, and then we put this from there, we put them into this here. But here you might confuse, there is a state and the variable. It is not there in shift reduce, no state information, and only the variables. And whenever we put into the first, initially it will be blank with dollar instead of S0. S0 is the LR parsing. I'll come to this. So whenever we put terminals, we try to find a handle. This is what is handle basically. Handle is a very unique thing, and handle means it is the rightmost derivation in the reverse way, the first sequence. Whenever you see the, you can reduce it to a production rule, you must reduce it. And remember, the handle will be, everything happens in stack in the top, nothing happens in the stack in the middle. So that is a good point of stack. That is a stack is a very good point. Everything is, happens at the top. So, and so your handle should occur in the top 2-3 positions or 4 positions. It may be here also, it may be top 3-4 positions, and there is no, only the here the terminals and variables, remember. And you push them, you try to whether it matches any handle. Handle means you right hand side, you can find a, if in the production rules you have a right hand side, a rule matches to the left hand side. So you have a, say, 3 or 4 production rules. If we, that if the, if you put all these things, you check it whether it matches. If it matches, you put this variable. But then there will be a problem, that is called reduction. Whenever you are replacing to that variable, that is called reduction. There might be error, reduction, that means you have a string of terminals or variables here, and there will be two rules. that is called the reduce reduce. When you are confused that whether reduction 1 will use or reduction 2 is used. So then we LR0 will come to help, we will come to that, and there may be shift reduce, because whenever you are seeing at a terminal here, you are not sure whether you want to shift it or you want to make it you want to go for reduction. That is also shift reduce error. Remember, there is no such error condition condition. The one is shift reduce confusion, one is reduce confusion means you can have 2-3 production rules, more than one production rules to reduce, that is reduce conflict, and another is shift reduce conflict, whether to shift it or reduce it. So that is a shift reduce conflict, and another concept you can think of that shift conflict. But no, shift conflict is never. It can be either shift reduce or reduce. If there is no shift reduce or reduce conflict, then the shift reduce is the best. If there is no such conflict, then shift reduce is best. But shift reduce grammar is very preliminary grammar. It is not powerful grammar. That means lot of languages you cannot catch it with the shift reduce grammar. So then the next advantage, next you go for the LR0 grammar. And LR0 grammar is slightly better than shift reduce grammar. But the LR0 grammar is a basic thing you have to understand. LR0 always, it is very interesting. LR0, they always in the stack right now till our LL1 parsing to still shift reduce parsing, we put the either terminals here, and the handle comes in the top, we reduce it to variables or terminals and variables. Not everything goes into it. You put one terminal, whether you see it, whether it can be reduced or it has to be shifted. So handle comes at the top of things, and the stack contains only initial stack is empty, and then the now LR0. What is interesting is we put a stack state, so and we put a stack state on the top of it, and later on we find we actually not store the variable, we store only the stack state. Though I have taken the diagram from famous book, but it will be stack state. We put the stack state here. Initial stack state should be S0. And what the stack state determines, what is the beneath condition of this? What is the condition here? It is a basically typically finite state machine sort of thing. It is a top state mentioned. What is the position here? And this has to be consulted with the only one token symbol. If you take the LR1, that is the most powerful parsing techniques. So you are taking the, but not LR0. LR0 only considers the stack state. But when the stack state with the one input symbol, that gives immense powerful to the grammar. So you don't need a left recursion to be removed like LL1 parsing. And this stack state determines how much you have covered, because whatever is here, that is mean it is consumed by the stack, and the stack is and with this you can fire the production rules. If then we have a table, then this table is action and go to. The action can be, it can be shift or reduce within this. Your input, if you say the function, the input only the top stack state, and this is the input. I am now considering here LR1, not LR0. LR0, do not look at it like a Gandhari sort of thing. LR0, Gandhari put a black robe on her eyes. So same is LR0. LR0, do not look at it. So LR0 is pretty less powerful. But for LR1 understanding, you have to understand LR0 and how to create the state number. I'll go to the details. Maybe today's class or my recorded class, how to state numbers is generated by items, LR items, and closer operation. I'll cover it to it. So ideally, the stack contains the stack state, and the stack state top of the stack state determines the what is beneath into it, and all of these things are required for finding handle. Handle, you remember, in a bottom-up parsing, in shift reduce parsing or LR0 parsing or LR1 parsing, the handle must be unique. You cannot have any parsing, you cannot have a two handles or alternative handles. If it's a two handles, then it's ambiguous grammar. So all unambiguous grammar should have only one and only handle, and that handle means the rightmost derivation in the reverse order, which comes first. If we detect the handle, for detection of handle, all these things are there. Shift reduce parser is all good, but if there's a conflict with shift reduce or reduce reduce, then we have to make a state information. What is behind, what is beneath the state, then we create a state information. We put S0 here. It is called, this is valid for LR0 and LR1. Shift reduce, no S0. And you put the state here. So all these parsing techniques, the stack is there. To summarize, the stack is initially in top-down parsing, it is starting symbol. And it's a dollar, always this dollar. This dollar is end marker of the input string, and this dollar is end marker of stack. Two different dollars. It is, don't confuse this dollar, this is the same. But remember, if you calculate the first and follow, particularly follow of S, this dollar should be there. So dollar is very important in input. Whenever you create a parsing table, the dollar should be one terminal. It come to the follow. And one thing, this is the top-down parsing, and the bottom-up parsing, we will start with the shift-reduce parsing. Shift-reduce parsing, there is no state. The only here the stack, and initially it will be empty with dollar, and here also dollar, and we put into input symbol here, and we always try to see whether we can reduce it or whether we put another terminal into it, and whether you see the top of the thing, can we make it's a handle or not. A handle is, what is a handle is? Handle is a unique pattern. You could find it, and you must find it in a bottom-up parsing. And there is no duplicate handle, and there is no conflicting handle. But if you can find your handle, that is the trick. If you can find the handle, then you can, your bottom-up parsing absolutely easier. It's like a cakewalk. But to detect the handle detection, you have to for shift reduce parsing, there's some conflict. Then we have to go LR0 parsing techniques. LR0 is for traditional, for your understanding only LR1. LR0, what we'll do, instead of the putting symbols here, you in the stack, we put down the stack information. What is the stack state? Sorry, that is stack state. Its stack state is nothing but the top of the stack state will tell, give idea what and what level of production rule you are. So by looking at it, you can fire the rules, and the very powerful things comes whenever you give a look at it, only one symbol, then we call LR1, not LR0, then it will be very, very powerful than LR0, and the LR1 parsing is one of the best parsing till now. It is a really comprehensive. It covers almost all 98% of programming language. Only problem is the algorithm is all same. LR0, SLR and LLR and LR1, algorithm is same, but the table will be different. These are the table. This is called action table. I'll come to this. What is action table? Here the columns should be your terminals, and the go to is the column should be the variables, and you know the what are the actions can be. So ultimately whether you get the handle reduce, or whether at the if you got everything and you got ace here, then you accept, that is accept, and if the error is there, then you declare error, and then this follow of this thing, you can you have to debug the error, where the error comes. You have to give the compiler output. Output should be that error, where it can be find out the error. So that's it. Yeah. Next, go to the next slide. That I have already done in a quiz. I think which of the following kinds of derivative LR parts are right modes in reverse? Yeah, and you know the famous computer scientist Donald Knuth, he developed this 1965. Remember, this is still now Turing machine is not used, though Turing machine has been written a seminal paper in 1937 by Alan Turing. But here the Donald Knuth, I think the volume of there are 7 volumes, Art of Programming. There are very good books that are available in the library. There is a fundamental things like Dijkstra, Donald Knuth, and von Neumann, Alan Turing. They are the particularly pillars of computer science. Yeah. So LRK parsing is done by Donald Knuth. And you remember the LaTeX, there is one famous programming language, and that not programming, formatting languages. Most of the books and all these things written in LaTeX, that is developed by solely, text is solely developed by Donald Knuth. Yeah, so this is, he invented it. I've covered it. So backtracking I've covered, predicting with the LLR parsing, the LLR parsing restriction I have covered. Then we cover shift reduce. Shift reduce is a really great, but the problem is when there's a conflict, the shift or reduce, reduce, which rule to fire, you cannot have a chance for hit and trial because then it will be same as the backtracking. So when to shift, when to reduce, and which reduce function, we need to have a put state information onto your stack. Then comes LR0 parsing, and actually one thing I have missed, that is operator precedence parsing. I have covered it. Operator precedence parsing is just for historical reasons. It is not very much used. Actually, more used is LALR. I'll come to this. Yeah, this is, I think I have covered in the class. What is the similarity LR? I have already, this is same different parsing table. You see the here, that is the interesting thing. You see it here, say LL1, LR1 is much more powerful. LL1 is here, LR1. So it LRK, if you can K look ahead, it will be a much bigger language, but generally it is not. The parsing table, even for LR1, for a standard programming languages, it may be 1 megabyte your entries. That is pretty big, because parsing table have to be in your computer memory, and that is pretty big. And that is generally created by, this parsing table entries is created by YAC, yet another compiler a program, and or Bison. There are two programs that are there where you input your CFG rules, and automatically the parsing table would be built. Because LL1 you can build your own parsing table by hand, but LR1 you cannot. Difficult. It's a, so 1 million entries. How can we make you minimum? How can we make it into this thing? So LR1 is suffice. So you don't need LR2 or LRK. So LR1. And if you see it here, LL0, LL1, LR0 is powerful. It is powerful. But see, L1 is much greater in power, LL1 even. But if you consider the LR1, that is really one big. This is LR1. We are concentrated on this. This is it. And here it will, everything it is mentioned, what is the advantage, and we'll come to this. Yeah. Same thing I have, this ambiguous grammar is no because we go to a deterministic pushdown automata on all the unambiguous grammar. And also you can, this thing, this area is interesting. There's some unambiguous grammar, you cannot find a LRK grammar. So no use of it. So in fact, our boundary should be LR1 or LLR1, because LR1 also, it takes huge parsing tables, and most of the programming language is done by LLR1. So this is the generally our boundary. Yeah. The operator precedence parsing, it is that in the right hand side, there will be two variables, and in between it, there is operator. So by this rule, it can't be. So this is not. But if you modify a little bit, this is the rule. It is good for operator precedence parsing. It is ideal case for bottom up parsing, but is very rule. It is for historical reasons. Operator precedence parsing is not much used, but you will get it in this book. Yeah, this operator precedence. Operator precedence grammar. I have covered the same thing. I have given a quiz answer, and that is the operator precedence grammar. the same. Yeah. Now come the shift reduced person. This is the portion is called handle. See, it comes handle always comes not at the end. It will not at the absolutely front. Maybe at the near beginning or near beginning, not at the end, because this is the handle. You have to detect the handle, and this is, yeah. Shift reduce parser is parse tag initially empty that I have told contains symbols already parsed. Yeah, that is if initially empty, but the symbols if it is there, it is already parsed. And elements in the stack are not terminal or non-terminal, so it mix. So it should be actually your handle should be come up there. You know handle. What is handle? Handle is any production rule right hand side. You can think of a handle that consists of a terminal and the variables. If as soon as you get a handle, it matches any right side of the production rule, you replace with that variable. That's it. So your stack should contain it is consist of terminal and non-terminal symbols. Yeah, the parse stack can remaining input and the parse stack contain remaining input always represent right side. Yes. Tokens are shifted on the stack until the top of the stack contains the handle. That's great. Handle, you don't, that I have tell again and again, handle should be at the top. That is great. Shift reduce parser, two questions. Have we reached the end of the handles? How long the handle? Which non-terminal does the handle reduce to? That is your main. So we use the tables. This is a parsing table, action and go to. Yeah, go to table, it is for variable and it is for terminal. I will see it. LR parser are driven by two tables, action table, which specifies action to be received. That I told four types of action, shift, reduce, accept and error. Accept at the last point when you get the, your stack should vanish, stack should come S, sorry, in the bottom of parser. At the end, the whole start symbol at your stack. And error, if error, it's that go to table, which specifies the state transition. We push states. Yeah, that is a very important thing. There, we generally the stack contains only states, and how to generate the states, that is given by the your YAC or Bison generated parsing table, the state information. We'll come to this. How the get the state information? The state number of states is huge. It can be huge. It may be. I told you, I mean, typical programming language. It may be 10^6 states or like this, 10^7. We push states rather than symbols on them. Not the stat consists of states. Each state represents a possible subtree of parse tree. Yep. So shift reduce parsing, initial and the final goal. So initially stack should be $ and input, all the input is here W, that is the strength, and at the end final is would be the your S should start symbol should be here and input is empty. That is the that is not all bottom up parsing. Stack initially should be empty and input all the W, that is string of characters, skin of terminals, sorry, skin of terminals, and after shift reduce and all these things, the S should come here. And whenever you go for LR0 and LR1, the initial stack other than $, there should be S0. S0 is the initial stack condition. So instead of $, it should be S0. And finally, there should be S0, S1. And no S here in LR0 or LR. That is the S1 means your S comes up here. Yeah. So that will come. This is a example of shift reduce parsing. So this is you'll get it, this kind of grammar. I'll request you, this is called expression grammar. The most of the arithmetical expression can be covered by expression grammar. And if you see initially stack is empty, this is your expression ID1, ID2. So you first go for shift. Now whenever you go for shift, this ID1 comes to the stack. I'm covering shift reduce, not LR0. Because LR0, the stack contains only the state. I'm again and again. And then this is the handle. See, this is it becomes a handle because this rule, you can go to this. So you've fired this rule. So it will go to it is converted, and now your star comes. This one car comes. Whenever you got it F, there's another handle. You go to like F. You take this rule to T. So it will be automatically come, T it will automatically come. So first handle is ID 1, then F and T, and then comes star, the T star. Then you again, then another thing is, you can go to ID 2, you shift ID 2, okay? But in ID 2, you can convert it to this rule. The ID 2, you shift it, ignoring, I'll come to this, why you are ignoring, that is the trick. So ID 2 shift it, and then you reduce it by F ID 2, then it is T star F, and here you see, from F you can go to another T here by reduction, but we will not do it. We will let it T star F, and we that rule will be fired. T star F to T, T star F to T, and then T to E. So there is a I make a preference. I am not taking the all the rules. Which rules are good for me, I am selecting. This is for a computer program is difficult. This is an example of shift reduce. So how to ignore and logical, I can create a state information and create a state information and then I'll do it. So this is a shift reduce parsing. Okay, so let's try. Very interesting, this LR parsing, L for left, I told you. Let's go to the next. Here it is the important thing, the how to make a LR0 parsing table. Say if you take this is a rule, I'll create a canonical set. So we'll make a, if we have these production rules, left hand side this and right hand side this, consists of parameters and variables. So I to want to see which position I am. So we have only one rule, A to XYZ. So I make four such rules. So I make a dot here, dot here, dot here, dot here. So your dot means where am I? Whether I am at the beginning of the handle, it can be a handle. So whether I am at the beginning of a handle, whether at the middle of the handle, whether another middle, whether the end, whenever your state is here and you see your left hand side is all handle, then I reduce it. That is called, so every production I'll make it this, and whenever dot comes here, that means you are here and left hand side are all your handle, then you must reduce it. That is LR0 item 0 creation. So we see it. Take the condition like these rules. I have make A to XYZ, I'll take so many rules, I take only this one, A to X dot, X dot YZ. So I can have, you think of, there is another two rules, production rule Y to U and Y to W. Okay, there's a, so I have a canonical LR0 items, I can create it, A to X dot Y, and whenever you are dot here, you are in the, within the handle, might be probably handle, and your whenever you are here, your first of whatever is, this should cover. So if we this is the Y is equal to dot U, your dot U, and so this is a whole set of canonical set. So you are here and whatever the first of this place. So if for this production rules Y to U and Y to W, so definitely you can add this. Okay, so this is it. So like this, we have creating a from a production rule. We can like you create your come Y variable. We can go to this. This is a functional state diagram. We'd make it. It's a kind of finite state machine with your production rules. And dots comes from beginning at the one variable or terminal next, then we created the collection state, then we can create the LR0 and LR1. Thank you for all.